Now, when the first wave of the internet washed over us with the dot-com revolution in the late 1990s, the number of women in technology was few and far between. But one female entrepreneur was such a standout in the technology field that she was dubbed Miss Internet by the media. This is her story.
Like many aspiring entrepreneurs, Silvia Moschini's journey began with taking a risk and leaving her corporate career behind.
When I was working for Visa, I was vice president of communications and internet for Latin America. And I found inside my soul that what I was doing and the way I was doing it, pushing projects and trying to drive change within an organization, was not the best use of my skills. So there I decided to take a big leap of faith, take a deep breath, and started my own company. And it was not a very easy thing to do.
That leap paid off as Silvina went on to become a successful serial entrepreneur and angel investor. Among her success stories, she founded the social media agency Intuic. That firm handles public relations and social media needs for clients including Google and Twitter. Another of her companies, Transparent Business, recently won a PC World Award as the best cloud computing solution for enterprise. The common goal in Silvina's companies is to have entrepreneurs, influencers, and executives thinking creatively about leveraging new advances in web technology to boost their bottom lines. But as with the first wave of the internet, Silvina is finding some companies are slow to get on board with how work culture is changing, especially for millennials.
Over the last 2 years, companies has been playing catch up to understand where the consumer was. And the same will happen with the work market. Right now, millennials are 25% of the U.S. workforce, but in 2020, they will be 75%, and companies are not ready.
With her latest startup, Yandiki, she continues to disrupt the traditional work culture by cultivating talent using the cloud.
I wanted to create opportunities for people from around the world to change the way they work, to being able to work over the internet, which is something that millennials truly appreciate. So I love technology, I love communications, and I love flexibility. So I wanted to create a company that will be fair for women, for millennials, and for people in remote places, so no longer where they live define where they work.
Seeing women fairly represented in the technology sector is a passion for Silvina. It's one of the reasons she's been an angel investor in women-led businesses. It's also a mentality she hopes to see reflected in Silicon Valley and beyond.